Hi again, Liz. The shoes and socks are off. Fiona's back in. Hey, Fiona. Jonathan Atkinson is back in. So all I need to do, guys, 5 minutes. Take my shoes and socks off. Get rid of my equipment. There we go. Lorraine Proud, Chris, I hope you're joining. Greg. Hi, Greg. How are you? Is Lorraine with you? If she is, how is Lorraine? Derek. Another freebie. Rich. Back in. Good, guys. Just going to wait for the class to fill up slightly. So this is Move and Improve tonight, guys. It's not your classic Move and Improve, as in it's, you know, a cardio session combined with movement exercises. It's going to be mobility and stretching, okay? Mr. and Mrs. B in the house. Obviously, I'm not going to try and sort of copy Graham because he's the master, the ninja of the stretch world. But I'll do my best to take you through all of the mobilities, especially some of the stuff that I use to help me with weightlifting and that sort of thing, okay? So, we're going to give it a few seconds. I feel like I'm cheating on Graham, guys. So these are coming in twice a week, so I believe on the timetable it's going to be Monday evening and Wednesday evening. Deb Flynn, how are you? Hope you're well. Stephen Day's in. Amy's back in. Good, guys, good. So it's only your half hour session, stretch and flex, and mobilisation. If you need some water, feel free. Wipe the centre heating up. Make it a bit sort of hot. Right, let's say 30 seconds, team. And I've got three chunks today. Three chunks of four exercises. First set of exercises is going to be your inchworms. We're going to take this really slow, feeling for a stretch. We're going to go into our lunge, hold, and reach. So more of a high lunge. Maybe looking to drop into a low lunge. We've got book openers and sumo squats, okay? So just really opening the hips, spine, and the hamstrings, okay? Not a posterior chain through there. Okay. Dave's in the house. Hi, Dave. I'm missing you, Dave. Hi, Shazeen. Back in. Right then, team. So, we're going to start. I'm going to put the timer on. We want three sort of 10 minute or so blocks for each one. More for reference for my end, okay? So clock's on. Let's hit the deck first, okay? And we're gonna lie long before we go into these inchworms, all right? So arms long, reach up nice and tall. Point the toes, don't arch the back too much. Okay, and try and stretch out through the shoulders. Three big breaths. And exhale, good. Last one. I'm thinking about trying to fill your belly when you breathe, guys, so it's diaphragmatic breaths, okay? Feel free to close your eyes during any of these stretches. Stay nice and long. Reach taller, try and get your toes to the wall in front of you. And release there, guys. Slowly come up to your feet. Okay. Now these may be slightly different to the inchworms you've done because we're gonna try and mobilize through the back at the same time, okay? So feet just outside, just on the mat at the edges or shoulder width apart. We're gonna roll down the chest. So chin to chest, roll down like so, okay? So I'm unwinding my spine, stretching through a little bit. Reach for the floor. Try and keep my legs straight and we walk out. Okay? Into a nice long position. Squeeze the bum. And now we're pushing the legs up. Nice and straight, bum in the air. Compress, so go into a halfway hold. And then we're coming back up. Like so. Chin off the chest, reach up, look up. Okay, close your mouth, stretch your neck. And repeat. So back down. Okay, close your curve over. Nice and slow, team. Walk it out. Okay, feel for the hamstrings. Reach forward if you want to. Work that core. Then we're going back. So legs straight. Push your bum up into the air. Okay, we're going to our halfway hold. And then we're raising up. Chin on the chest. Big breath in. And exhale, guys. Two more we're gonna do. Reach down, curling through the spine, chin to your chest, walk out. And then walk back in. Try and keep those legs straight. If we need to, go wider with your legs. Push up, halfway hold. Then we're coming up nice and slow. So chest up, big breath in, looking up, mouth closed, stretch out your neck. And release, one more. Okay, bum goes back, chin to chest, curl down. It's what we call a Jefferson curl. Reach for the floor, walk out. Stretch out if you need to, and then back in. So legs nice and straight. Halfway hold, raise up, chin to your chest. Up you go. This time we're gonna reach up tall. Stretch up, stretch shoulders, big breath in. And release there, guys. Okay, so that's number one done. Now we're gonna go into our reverse lunge position. So go onto the center of your mat. Okay, we're gonna go either, if you want to, and you feel a bit more stretch this way, big breath in, reach up, hold that position there, squeeze our bum, so we're pushing onto our hip flexors, and drive forward into that stretch. If you want to, you can go knee down. Big breath in, reach up, reach for the sky, neutral hands, and release, okay? So we're gonna go for five on each side. Two. Good. Three, squeeze the bum. Four. And last one, five. And swap over legs, guys. So any version you were doing, either high lunge or low lunge. Okay, this is your high lunge. Okay, we can do this one. Okay. But you can go knee down if you need to, right? I prefer knee down, I can drive my hips forward a little bit more. So big breath in. Reach forward, raise up. Remember, squeezing that bum. That's two. Three. Four. Last one. Five, guys, remember, fill your belly with breath, okay? Try and connect with that breath. Right, two more we're gonna do, okay? So we've got book opener. So let's start by going onto our side, okay? We're gonna go bottom leg straight. So for me, left leg straight, right leg's bent at 90 degrees. I think you should all be able to see this one. If you need a pillow, pillow here. We're gonna do 10 on each side, nice and slow, okay? So we're gonna reach forward, separate the shoulder blades here, and then breathe out. Rotate over. You might get a few pops and clicks, which is really nice. Try and get this shoulder blade as close to the floor as you can. That's one, okay? And open up, breathe out. two. Three. Four. And we should start feeling ourselves loosen up a little bit now, guys. Five. Six. I actually really need this. Seven. Eight. Nine, last one on this side, guys. We're gonna be loosey-goosey after this. And release there, guys, well done. So on to the other side, okay? So I'm gonna turn around, you don't necessarily need to. So for me, my left leg is at the top now. My right leg is straight, okay? Support your head with a pillow if you need to. We reach forwards, separate the shoulder blades, open up, breathe out. And I'm tight on this side. One. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Last two for me, guys, should be there or thereabouts with me. Nine. And 10. Hold it there for a moment. Come back over. Child's pose. Just stretch out through. Reset everything, okay? So bum to the hocks. Reach forward, reset. Okay, guys. Last one on this set we're gonna do is sumo squats. It's only 10 reps just to open up the hips. Okay, then we're gonna move on to our second section, okay? So for me, I'd like to go nice and wide. Okay, whoop. We need the bum to go back, we need the knees to go forward, so we're nice and upright, okay? So I'm gonna drop into a sumo squat first off. 10 reps, do it with me. We're gonna rotate each way on each one, okay? So lower down, hands in this position, knees nice and wide, rotate, and up. Okay, down, knees wide, rotate, back up, okay? Three, squeeze your bum at the top. Four, and you should feel yourself sinking into that stretch a little bit more now. There. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. Last one. 10. Good. Well done, guys. Grab some water. You're going to feel the quads start to burn now. And feel the hips nice and open, okay? So, 30 seconds. Grab some water. We're going into block two now. So, we've got world's greatest stretch. We've got pigeon pose, child's pose, groin stretch. Thread the needle, a bit more rotation. Lateral lunge and reach, okay? So you can almost see the theme with this this session. Bit of stretching, bit of mobilization, bit of priming activation, okay, for want of a better word. Okay, 15 seconds. Any comments so far? Let me know. Oh, my trainers in isolation at home. Yeah, I've got to walk home barefoot. Always making the funnies, Dave, love it. Okay, so our world's greatest stretch, right? So we're gonna do a few moving parts this one. We're gonna do five on each side, okay? So let's start in a presser position. Okay, so do it with me, team. Here, we're gonna bring our left foot up to our left hand, like so. All right, now from here, my right knee goes to the floor, and I'm gonna sit back onto my bum to heel, stretching out through the hamstring here, okay? Reach forward now, squeeze the bum, open the hips up, so you feel that nice big hip flexor stretch. Elbow to the floor, and rotate three times. One, two, three, good. So, foot goes back down, right foot to right hand. Okay, knee goes down and we sit back onto our hamstring stretch. Chest up tall, no rounding through the spine. Okay, roll forward, squeeze the bum, so open up the hips now, and then elbow to the floor. Rotate three times. One, two, three. Okay, repeat, left side. Okay, now from here, sit back with your hamstring stretch. I think these take a bit of time. We'll do three on each side on these ones, guys. Reach forward, squeeze your butt, open up your hips. Feels good. Elbow to the floor. Rotate three times. One, two, three. Good. And swap over. So this is going to be our second one on both sides. So sit back, stretch out the hamstrings, chest up nice and tall. Okay, lean forward, squeeze the bum, stretch out through the hips. Elbow to the floor. Rotate three times. One, touch, two, and three. Good. So last one on each side. Forward. If you can, push that stretch a little bit more now, guys. Knee to the floor. Okay, sit back into your hip hamstring stretch. Chest up tall. Okay, release forward. Hip flexor stretch. Elbow to the floor, and rotate three times. One, two, three. Good, swap over. Last one, guys. Okay, so knee to the floor. Sit back into your hamstring stretch, really push it this time. Keep your chest up, tuck your bum back. Reach forward. Squeeze that bum, open the hips, elbow to the floor, or as close to the floor as you can. Rotate, one, two, three. Good. Foot goes back. Okay, just give yourself a little moment just to loosen up the hips, okay? So there's a lot of hip work there, all right? Next one is going to be our child's pose, and we're going to go for a groin stretch on this one, so inner thigh stretch. Okay, go on to all fours. Nice wide position like this. Okay, we're gonna go into our child's pose first off originally. Try and open those hips a little bit more first, okay? So bum nice and low to the floor, reach forward. Three more deep breaths, guys. Two. So we're starting to open up those shoulders a little bit through there now, through that spine, okay? So knee comes back to the centre, foot goes out nice and wide. We're going to push our bum back and we're going to rock and do 10 reps pulsing here. So that's 1, 2, 3. If you can, you can open up that toe. 4, get a bit more of a stretch. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Last one. 10. Good. Back to child's pose. Knees nice and wide, toes together, bum low, chest forward, stretch out through the shoulders, lower back, and groin. 3 deep breaths, guys. Okay, now come up, same on your other side now. So, for me, left leg goes back, knees to the centre, start up on upright position, quadruped position, and sinking into that stretch. So 10 rocks in position. 1, 2, no rounding, guys, so you need to keep that nice straight back, okay? 3, 2, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Perfect. Okay, thread the needle, 10 on each side, guys. I do like this one. Okay, so it's gonna be all four position. Now what I like to do is my hand goes around the lamppost, up the road. Get the elbow to the floor, twist. You'll feel that separation in the upper back and open up, okay? Round the tree or round the lamppost, up the road. And through. So we go 10. 3. 4. Five, 6, 7, 8, 2 more, 9, remember round the lamppost, up the road, get the elbow nice to the floor, and there we go, guys, swap over, reach around, and open up. 1. Use your breath as well, guys. Release that breath in the bottom position. 3, 4, 5, 6. 7, 8, 9, last one, 10, good. Come up to your feet, guys, last exercise on this block, okay? It's gonna be lateral lunge, so for me, nice and wide with your feet. Okay, just keep them in position, I would, because it saves you trying to find the correct foot position each time, okay? For the sake of stretching, this one will be fine. My bum goes over to that corner pocket, okay, to here. I'm gonna try and touch the floor if I can, and touch my foot, raise up, back to start, okay? I'll do it on my right side, so reach the floor, raise up, back to start. So we'll do those 10 on each side, okay? That's 2, guys. Hinge over, touch that foot, raise up. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, last one. There we go. Tricky that one. Grab some water, guys, a few minutes or a few seconds. We're going into our last sequence, okay? So we've got downward dog scap push-ups, 90-90 hip switch, and we're gonna do a glute bridge to finish, okay? So, 30 seconds. When you're ready, guys, we're gonna start on our hands in a press-up position. Do like a downward dog. So that's coming up next. So downward dog into scap push-ups, okay? So if I start on all fours, all right? With a downward dog, if people can get to there, brilliant, okay? But the key with your downward dog is gonna be having a straight line through your hands, elbows, shoulders, all the way up to your tailbone, okay? If you've got straight legs and you're rounding, then that's not really achieving the same goal, okay? So if you need to, bend your legs, there's no shame in that. Okay, when I'm tight, I have to bend my legs just to get that good downward dog position, okay? So here, we're gonna roll forward to there, squeeze, scap press up. Okay, bum goes up, downward dog. Roll forward, scap press up. Back in. If you want to go lower, guys, on your dive bomber, feel free. So downward dog, dive bomber, up, scap press up. So scap press ups, chest goes low, shoulder blades come together, press up and away, okay? Downward dog, dive bomber, scap press up. Last one, downward dog, dive bomber, reset, scap press up. Good. Quite tricky on the shoulders, that, but a really nice opener. Okay, so we're going into our 90-90 hip switch now. We're gonna go 10 each way. For me on this one, I either like to be hands behind me, rotate from side to side, pause in. Or you can go to the floor and you can do it that way. I like going to the floor, so I'm gonna do it on the floor, so if you want to, do it with me. Okay, so knees like so, drop, knees down from side to side. 5 each way, 10 in total. It's 2, 3, 4. Release your breath on the way down. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, last one, 10. Okay, guys, we're gonna finish off with glute bridges, 10 reps. And we're gonna unwind the vertebrae by vertebrae on the way down, okay guys? So for me, I like to go outside hip width with the feet, so making sure we're using those glutes. Okay, I'm gonna go up into my glute bridge, and now I'm unwinding my spine, pushing each vertebrae into the floor until I get to my tailbone. Squeeze that tailbone into the floor, use my abs, okay, and release. Back up, we're going for 10 reps. Unwind. Squeeze my abs, tailbone into the floor. 2, and release. Up, glute bridge. Unwind. And release. 3, glute bridge. Release the breath as we lower. 5, up, squeeze the bum hard, lower down. Six, up, unwind. Seven, squeeze, unwind the spine, guys, relax through that spine. Push it into the ground using the abs. Eight, unwind. Nine, release. Last one, unwind. Nice and slow. Okay, that's your 10 done, team. So let's lie nice and long now. We should feel a little bit taller. Legs nice and long, point the toes, get the toes to the wall. Now heels to the wall. Reach up nice and tall, reach up long. We should definitely feel as if there's less pressure when we're in this position now, guys. So we should feel a bit looser and a bit more comfortable holding our bum, shoulder blades, and feet on the floor with our hands touching if you can. So just gonna hold here now, eyes closed. Three deep breaths. Inhale. Big breathy breath. Guys, just come up to a seated position now, nice and slow. I'm hoping, if you're like me, I'm feeling really relaxed now. Okay, feel a little bit looser. Hope you enjoyed that. Different spin on things potentially from what Graham does, but I'll be around for a minute. If you've got any comments, any feedback would be amazing, guys. The next session we'll focus a little bit more less on hips and rotation, a little bit more through our shoulder girdle and upper back, guys, and maybe some stuff for the neck, okay? So at the moment a lot of us are going to be sat at the desk. So if we open up that neck a little bit more, it's going to help us a little bit. Watching with a glass of wine. Didn't really enjoy working out everyone. Thanks, Dave. Yeah, guys, any comments, post them below. Failing that. I'll see you in the morning. Okay, guys, I'll be here for strength session, early doors, and then a HIIT session, I believe, is following, okay? Good, Jonathan, thank you for joining me for both sessions. No problem, Greg and Lorraine, glad you enjoyed it. Thank you, Amy, just what I needed. No problem. Lorraine, great, thanks, Dan. You're the one I wanted to impress, Lorraine. but yeah, nice way to end the day, I think. Relax. Now you can open the glass of wine, a bottle of wine. Okay, guys, enjoy your evening. If there's no more comments, I will see you all early in the morning. I'll just refresh, just make sure there's nothing else. Good. Right, guys, well done, team. If you join me for both sessions, thank you. You're bored of me now, so go and watch something a bit more interesting on television. And I will see you. Thanks, Graham. I've got the Graham seal of approval. I will see you all tomorrow morning, early doors. Be there, be square. Thank you.